of the faithfulness of your blessings and your hands that you have on these individuals.
Amen.
So, Father, we thank you for what you're going to do in Alicia's life. Father, we thank you for what you're going to do in the others' lives, Father, who's struggling with similar things.
Yes, Lord.
We pray in Jesus Christ's name.
Amen. Amen. Lord, Amen. We just thank you for Cindy right now, and she's pregnant, oh God, and we just thank you for strength upon her, oh God, in her pregnancy. Ask for strength, oh God, each and every day as she goes about the things she needs to do. We just speak strength. We just speak strength over Cindy. We speak strength each and every day, oh God, that you will strengthen her body, strengthen her mind to go through this stage in her life in the name of Jesus. And even for her baby, unborn baby, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we just praise you for you are watching over them. We thank you, Father, for your protection. For your protection, and we declare there will be no complication, there will be nothing that you will keep from day one, oh God, to the time of delivery for Cindy, in the name of the Lord Jesus. From day one, oh God, to delivery. This we give you thanks for. Your word says you will give your angels charge over us, over Cindy, to keep her in all her ways as she goes about this time, oh God, until delivery. This we give you thanks for. And we declare from today there will be no complication. The delivery will be smooth and everything will come out good. This we give you thanks for. This we give you praise for, oh God. It says, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty, oh God. And we declare protection over Cindy, over her family, over everything that she does, over her concern, oh God. You have loved her with an everlasting love, and your love brings protection, your love brings care, and all that is required. This we thank you for. Hallelujah.
Thank
to your
you,
name.
Father.
Amen. Thank and amen. Amen. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Father, we want to pray for Lila. She has pain from meds that she has been taking is now affecting her organ. Father, right now, I come against, Father, the medication that's supposed to help and assist her deal with her pain is now affecting her body. So, Father, right now, we need your supernatural power to touch her life. And, Father, to touch the origin of that pain. So, Father, right now we're asking you to heal her. Of that she doesn't even have to take the meds. But, Father, right now we're asking you to touch her.
Yes, Lord.
To even, Father, the medicine that's been affecting her organs, Father, we ask you for wholeness.
Supernatural.
To make her organs whole again.
Yes, Lord.
That after the medication, Father, we ask you.
Yes, Lord.
But if it's another medication, Father, or you just want to bless and wholly heal her right now, stand in agreement with that.
Yes,
so, Father,
Lord,
right now we're asking you to intervene in the situation in her life. Move, Father, and the only way you can move, Father, give the doctors, Father, the pharmacists, whoever is in her life, Father, the wisdom and knowledge, Father, to say take this or take that. And when it's beyond them, Father, we ask in you that you touch and you move in her life.
Amen.
I pray this in your son, Jesus Christ's name.
Amen.
And amen. Amen.
Lord,
amen.
We just praise you in the same way we just praise you for ministers, pastors all over, churches all over in our cities, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we will not stop praying for the ministers and pastors and leaders, oh God, of different denominations, oh God. We thank you for your grace, even as we heard this morning, that your grace is sufficient, oh God. And we declare that your strength is made perfect in their weaknesses, the challenges they're going through in bringing leadership to their churches and organizations, oh God. We pray in the name of the Lord Jesus that you strengthen them. Oh, I hear the word stretch. You're stretching them. You're stretching them, oh God, and your grace is sufficient.
Yes,
it seems the situation,
Lord,
is stretching them, but your grace is sufficient. Your grace is enough.
Yes.
It's enough for that situation, oh God. Even some of the churches and organizations going through tough times with their finances, oh God, we declare provision in the name of Jesus. We declare provision. The heart of the king is in the hand of the Lord. You're touching people from the east, the west, the north, and south to send them help that is needed to keep that ministry going. In the name of Jesus, we just praise you. I'm so excited, Lord, because you You just ministered to my heart. Now that is done already. You just ministered that he is done already. That they should just take what you've made available for them.
Yes,
that they should just take it, Father. That is what you're saying to me this morning. That they should just take it. They should just take it. Because when you call them in, you call them in with the provision. When you call them in, it included the supply. Everything was there. Whether in the times that were bad, in the times of pandemic and the times of plenty, the provision is always there. Always there.
Yes,
you're making me understand now that it's always there. And I pray that you open their eyes to see, oh God. As your word says, the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. Father, we give you praise. You say it's already there. It is done. My provision is constantly with you. God's servants, now God is saying to you, the provisions are there. Take it. It belongs to you. Look out. Look down. Look around you. It is there because God sent it from the beginning, from the day he called you for the assignment. He called you with the provisions included.
Yes,
and Father, we thank you that their eyes are open to the supply. Their eyes are open to the protection. Their eyes are open to understand, oh God, that you are their glory and the lifter up of their heads, oh God. And we come against the spirit of discouragement for ministers and depression. We understand that a lot of them have given up on ministry. And we know, Lord, that is not your will.
Yes, yes, Lord.
And we ask that wherever they are, you strengthen their hearts again. That they will rise up again and get into the assignment, because there's no time that is as important as this where we need to stay in the place of our calling.
Yes.
For the world is bleeding right now, and there is need for supernatural intervention and healing in the hearts of people all over the world. And we cannot afford to sign off right now. In the name of Jesus, I pray for the ministers of the gospel all the way here from Boston, Randolph, into Massachusetts, the nations of the world, east, west, north, and south, Africa, Europe, wherever they are, strengthen their arms, oh God. The same way Nehemiah was encouraged, oh God, when you dropped it in his heart to go back, oh God, and rebuild the works, oh God.
Yes,
he faced challenges, oh God, the threat of his life, a discouragement and lack of provision. But Lord, you favored him in the eyes of the king, and he found all that was needed to rebuild the world.
Yes.
And Lord, I pray for ministers. I pray for pastors, even in the urban areas, the remote areas, all the way down near, in the forest, in Africa, wherever they are, oh God.
Yes,
wherever they are, oh God. Those who are having services underground, right now, grace is sufficient. You told us this morning. And that grace, your ability. Thank you, Jesus. That their eyes will be open to see. We function in surplus. That is what you're saying to us this morning. Ministers of the gospel. God is saying that there is so much. The kingdom never lacks. Listen now. The kingdom never lacks. We have so much. Take it. Take it right now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, we pray that their eyes and our hearts will be open, oh God.
Yes, Lord.
Open to the supply. And you bring it to my mind right now as I'm praying for them. There was no time Jesus ever was in need. Whenever the need showed up, the supply was there.
Yes.
He told Peter,
Lord,
just go into the sea and cast your net. And he did. And there he picked up a fish and paid. Whenever there was a need, the supply was always there. And God is saying, pastors, you may not see the millions and thousands, but whenever there is a need, look at it, look around.
Yes,
God, always, he did that for Abraham.
Yes,
the ram for the sacrifice. It's not always far away. Listen, the lamb for the sacrifice is not always far away. It's there.
Yes,
as we walk in obedience, oh God, I pray for pastors, bishops, or leaders, oh God, of churches all over the world,
Lord.
Oh God.
Yes, Lord.
That they be strengthened. And even pastors that are not known, oh God, just there wondering, but are faithful to the calling. My heart goes out. Our hearts goes out for them right now. Even pastors who lost their members and as a result of this virus, oh God, that you will strengthen their hearts. Some have asked the question, Lord, if you are for us, why did my members die? Lord, if you are for us, some of the, Jesus, even some believers are asking, Lord, if you are for us, if you are real, why did you allow our pastor to die from the coronavirus?
Yes, Lord.
Why did you allow this to happen? A lot of questions in your hearts, oh God. But we pray for your children, believers all over the world.
Lord.
Believers all over the world. strengthen their hearts. We don't lose.
Mm.
Your word says your grace is sufficient. And we pray, oh God, that you will help each and every one of us to stand in the gap for one another in this time. Because your word have declared it that we are more than conquerors. We win, oh God. And I pray for unity in the body of Christ. Unity among pastors, oh God. Unity among believers. Because we are the answer to the world. We are the ones to bring healing to the world. And we cannot back out at this time. We cannot be numbered among the discouraged. God forbid. We cannot be numbered amongst the depressed. We cannot be numbered among the confused. So who will help the world? Your word says, let our light so shine before men. In Isaiah 6, they said, the world shall be filled with gross darkness. And that is what we experience today. When a lot of people are going through mental challenges, whatever be their situation, it's darkness. It's darkness. It's darkness. And you say, but arise and shine. Your light has come. That all will come to your light, oh God. Thank you, Father.
Yes.
Thank you, Father. We refuse to be discouraged.
Mm.
And as families all the way, wherever they are, families confused.
Yes, Lord.
Bring healing togetherness. Yes. And Lord, as they call upon you, as they seek your face, as they open their hearts to worship, you reveal yourself to them. You were there with Abraham in the time of famine, with Isaac. Oh, Jesus. You never leave or forsake your own.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Father, I pray, rise up in time and meet their needs.
Yes.
So that the righteous will not murmur and complain and voice with their mouth that you are not good, because we know that you are good.
Yes.
This
Lord.
Is our prayer today.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Heavenly Father, just as your man of God was praying, you laid on my heart to pray for the South American countries, Father, where we see political unrest. Father, we ask you for the pastors, Father, and the leaders, the church leaders in those places, Father, to have wisdom, Father. Give them what they need in order to touch the people's heart, Father. Give them a word. Give them hope. Encourage them, Father, through the word. Father, we ask you to raise up these pastors throughout this continent, Father.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
That they may give hope that they need. Father, I pray for those in the region where there's no medical supply, that, Father, that you will just supernaturally heal those individuals. Father, whatever ailment, whatever they're going through, that, Father, that your healing power, that you will put a hedge of protection, Father, that sickness would not even hit them. Father, we're asking you of those who need, Father, that have the fertile ground that they can plant the seeds, Father. Let those seeds, Father, return them, Father, a hundredfold. That, Father, that they can supply those things, Father, according to your truth. Just ask, Father, as they take your word and they plant it in the good soil of their heart, that they reap a harvest.
Yes, Lord God.
So, Father, so is in the spirit, so let it be natural.
Yes, Lord God.
So, Father, we pray for those in the Asian areas, Father.
Yes, Jesus.
Where the government doesn't allow for religious freedom. But, Father, right now we ask in you to give them hope, to give them the promise that in the midst of all that, that you're still moving, Father. And in the midst of all that, Father, your word is still spoken, Father. In the midst of all that, your truths, Father, are being walked out, Father. In the midst of all that, the trust and belief in your word, Father, are being moved and talked out and preached and walked out in these individuals' lives across this nation. And Father, we thank you for what you're doing in this season and what you're doing. And let us not miss your move or what you're speaking or what you're saying. Father, you said those who have a ear, let them hear. So, Father, let us not miss. Let us not be distracted.
Thank you, Lord.
By these lives issues and these problems.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Father, let us be in tune in you.
Hallelujah.
Father, wherever we are, whatever is going to happen in our lives, that we're connected to you because of the promise, Father, because of the relationship that you established. Father, because, Father, you're reconciling us back to you. Father, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
That as we pray, that as we meditate on your word, that your truth will be revealed in our lives, in the lives of your people. We thank you, Father. We praise you. We honor you. Father, I lift up Adele this morning. Jesus. Father, that she's been struggling with a cough. Mm-hmm. She has a respiratory situation. Mm-hmm. So, Father, right now I'm asking you, your daughter, Father, that you touch her this morning. That, Father, that you heal her, that you take her through the process and let her know that you're there, Father, that you're not leaving her, saying that, Father, that you're there with her every step, Father, with every cough, Father, let them know that's there with every breath that you breathe, Father, let them know that you're there. Father, I'm asking you to breathe your healing breath into her body.
Yes, Jesus.
Father, I thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
For our sister's life, Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, for the promise, Father, we thank you for the dedication that you have given. Father, we thank you, Father, for her trustworthiness, Father, with your word of promise, Father. We thank you, Father, for walking out the truth, Father. We thank you for the giftings that you have placed in her life, Father. We thank you for responding, Father, to the cry of your people. We thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
So, Father, because of her faithfulness and the things that you have called her, so, Father, hear her voice this morning as she cries out to you to heal her of this ailment, Father, to heal her, Father, of this cough, to heal her, Father, of this respiratory situation that she's been struggling with.
Yes.
And, Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
For your grace. Mm-hmm. Father, we thank you for the mercy in her life that you allowed her to walk out.
Hallelujah.
We pray in Jesus Christ's name.
Amen. Father, we just thank you for the country, Benin right now at war. Oh, Jesus, we pray, oh God, that your mercy will flow, that in the name of Jesus, let there be peace in these nations, oh God. It's your will. It's your will that none perish, oh God, but that all comes to repentance. We are asking, oh God, this nation at war right now, oh God, we ask, oh God, that you go ahead. We ask, Lord, that you go ahead, oh God, and whatever will bring about peace in this nation, in the name of Jesus. Because the hearts, oh God, in the midst of pandemic and war, in the midst of pandemic, oh Lord, we ask that your mercy will prevail in the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. We praise your holy name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah to your name. We praise you right now. We ask for covering for those who, oh God, who are right there, oh God, or the churches, oh God, whatever every other thing, oh God, that is going on in those nations, oh God. We ask, oh God, that your wisdom will prevail, that your wisdom will prevail. The covering of the churches and the citizens in the name of Jesus right now.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, the leaders, all, oh God, those who are in authority, in the name of Jesus, we declare that you cover them, oh God. Protection, oh God. And we declare peace in that nation. Peace in that nation, in the name of Jesus. Peace in that nation. And your name alone glorified forever. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Father, right now, we just lift up Cameron. He's praying for wisdom. Father, as he goes into manhood, Father, we just pray over this young man. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you that your truths of your word will walk out into his life, that he'll recognize or realize, Father, the calling and purpose that you have brought him to the kingdom at such a time as this. Father, you said that those who ask for wisdom, Jesus, he gives it freely. Only thing we have to ask. So, Father, we ask you to give him wisdom beyond his age, beyond his education, beyond his environment that he's in, that, Father, that he would be staying, Father, that he would be focused on the things that you have called him to
thank
do.
Thank you, Jesus.
That, Father, that he would walk in promises as a male, as a man.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the kingdom of God. Father, let him be favored by you.
Hallelujah.
Father, let grace and mercy follow him everywhere he goes.
Amen.
Father, sustain him.
Yes, Lord.
And Father, let the promise of your truths, of your word, Father, illuminate for him.
Glory
that
to
he may touch, that he may other young men, that other men may come and follow him because of the truth of the word that you have supplanted in his heart for such a time as this.
Hallelujah.
I pray in Jesus' name.
Amen. Father, we pray for Nisi recovering from a surgery right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for that for that speedy recovery. We thank you for supernatural intervention in the name of Jesus, that everything that needs to come together for full recovery, that needs to come together for full recovery, we declare supernatural intervention, God, that everything will stabilize, God, that the recovery will be speedy, God. And this we give you thanks for all that is required. The body responds to treatment and everything comes in place. And this we give you thanks. This we give you glory for. In the name of our Lord Jesus, we praise you. Hallelujah. Mm. Hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, I just right now, I just looked up brief about Naomi. Naomi has sent in a prayer. Parents has sent in a prayer a while ago about Crohn's disease that she was born. Father, we just thank you for what you've been doing in her life.
Thank you, Jesus.
And Father just said that she is struggling a little bit. She has a little disappointing news about the treatment that she has. So, Father, right now I'm asking you to touch this young lady. Father, give the medical staff, Father, the wisdom and knowledge that they need in order to make the right decisions, Father, for this young lady. Father, we ask in you, Father, until her whole and a fullness of healing comes to fruition. Father, I'm asking you to give her that grace, Father, give her that patience, to give her that trust, to give her the encouragement that she needs, that Father, that she knows, regardless of what she goes through, the process that you have taken through, Father, she trusts in you. She trusts in your word. Father, she trusts in the promises that she see and she see walked out, Father, with her parents. Father, she believe in the trust and the worship, Father, of your word. So, Father, let your word of truth reign in this young lady's life. And let us, Father, not get depressed. Let her not get sad. Let her not be disappointed. But, Father, let her be encouraged because of what you're going to do in her life.
Yes,
Father, it says with your joy. Let the joy return to us. Let her rejoice in the things that you are going to do in her life.
Amen.
We pray in Jesus Christ's name.
Amen. Father, we just thank you for Vanessa covering her and her family in the name of Jesus right now. Your protection upon them, your provision upon them, your deliverance. Father, we thank you for her life and her family, oh God. Father, we ask, oh God, whatever has been difficult for them, whatever the situation be, whatever they've been asking you for help and wisdom and asking for light concerning, oh God, we ask, oh God, that you make it possible in the name of Jesus. We declare fruitfulness upon that family. We declare your provision upon them, your protection, and we declare abundance for them, abundance, oh God. We declare joy in that home for her family. We declare joy and peace in the name of the Lord Jesus. We declare that your blood speaks on their behalf. Whatever the plot of the enemy is against them, we cancel it in the name of Jesus and speak your protection and speak your provision and speak your life constantly in them. Thank you, Father. We praise your name. We glorify you, O God, and declare peace and prosperity upon Vanessa and our family in the name of Jesus, glorified. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
And once again, we just really thank you for this awesome time that God given us to spend with you and pray with you in partnership with you. We just want you to continue to tune in with Let Us Pray from 7 to 8. We just thank you. Father, we just thank you for what you're doing in this ministry. Father, we thank you for all the ones who had emailed, who had texted in and sent in their prayers, that we are able to stand with them.
Yes.
And Father, even the ones that we receive after this program is over, that we let them know and trust that we're still going to stand in unison with them with prayer.
Yes.
And also, Father, we just thank you for the ministry of the principles and promises of
Jesus.
You. Father, under your servant, Father, Pastor Stephen Mack, Father, we thank you for the ministry that you're giving him. And then we thank you for all that you're going to do in his life and the impact that he's going to have in the life of your people. We pray in Jesus Christ's name.
Amen. We're excited and we want to thank God for your live viewers. And this is NACTN, New England Christian Television Network. We encourage you to join us. Follow us on our Facebook, all of the link, Amazon and every other thing you can see on there. Just join us. I mean, God is doing so much here from this network. And I tell you, lives are changed. Our lives are being blessed. We want to encourage you. Share this with your friends. Encourage others. Anytime you tune in on to NACTN, you have something that is going to bless you.
Amen. So
we have a lot of programs. And I tell you, God is at work here in New England. I tell you, with your eyes, you see the glory of God. The scripture says, in the last days, the whole earth shall be filled with the knowledge of God as the waters cover the sea. God bless you and have a blessed day. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Father, thank we just thank you for all the prayer requests that we sent in today. Father, we thank you that you've given us pray in your Son, Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Thank you, Father.